morning. Good morning, Lola Williams. Princess Gloria, thank you. Lady Ruth, my beautiful sister. How your daily Adeyemi? What's up? Michelle, how you doing this morning? King Sammy, what's up, beloved Rumi? And why yellow for you all? Come on.
You are lifted up.
That's what I'm saying. Come
on. You are lifted up.
Come and jump up with me. Everybody lift him up. Come on, come on, come on, come on, lift him up. You better begin to dance this morning because it's gonna be a roller coaster broadcast today. What you got to know about your wife before you enter into 2017? Kenny Ojo, how you doing? Lady Ruth dancing already. Come on. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Come on. Olu Afunke. Shama. Yay. Shama. Good morning. Darani Joe, what's up? IK, how you doing? Good morning. Kenny Ojo. You give you glory. Olu Afunke, good morning, my sister. As you're coming in, go ahead and start the video on your page because it's going to be crazy. Jehovah Shama. Oluwa Toyin Omolayo. Good morning. My money. Yeah. As you're coming in, go ahead and share the video on your page. Let's get more people to connect. Very important for people to connect this morning because we're going to be instructing people. It's a brand new show, ladies and gentlemen. Listen. Inspiration AI, you know. Yay! Onishara, Onisha Iyan, Onishara, Lord Loru, Mio Boss, hey, Lazizi, David, Oluwabemi, Onisha, Sami, Bambi, Onishara, Lord, beloved Fumi, I didn't see your face. I see you there. Oh, Ola Tunde Jima, Babani, my bad, Mogidi. Agumba Chiku came. God bless you. And I greet you too. Evelyn Osage. Good morning. Roselyn Abiola. How you doing? Good afternoon. Yay, my people. It's going to be crazy this morning. I don't have enough time, but listen. Share the video real quick. Let more people connect. Bonjour, Karen. God bless you. Thank you very much. All the way from Northeast England. Thank you. Share the video real quick. Oloruko Nla. Hey, Oruko Jesu. Okaria. Emmanuel Edwin. Oloruko Nla. Oruko Jesu. Osamede. Ade Bisayo. Yeye. Oruko Jesu. Precious Ganu. All right, good one. Yay. Keeper of life, prosperity, Lord. Are you ready? Go.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Everybody say. Yay. Come on, man. Go back to my keeper of life. Are you ready? Lord. You are God. Belongs to you. My life belongs to you. My love belongs to you. Everybody say, bonjour. Bim Stevie, God bless you. Nero Oni, all the way from Houston, Texas. My hair, Salofa, go on in Houston. Uliwari, your sound is up here. What you want my phone? My phone is soccer punch. You know? Ready? Are you ready? Come on. Are you ready? Listen, that's it. Come on. Yay.
Mighty King of Glory, we give you praise.
Who can deny you are Lord of Let's see, I just say, how you doing? Greece, what's up? Freeman, how you doing today?
No other God can be like you, you're so awesome. Who can
Wait, no, I didn't come. Baby, what's up? Baby. You mean you are going and you run away in your misery? Or like you mock at Adebayo? They never burn them. Come on, who can deny? Who? I pray, Baba Mio. Only you will I pray. I have no other God. Are you ready? Yeah. Only you will. Becky Godwin. Bukola. Saki Oye. How you doing? Yeah. My friend. Bring it down. Let's get to the business of today. All right. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I just love you guys so much, man. I'm telling you, man. I just love you guys. 8:22 this morning, by the grace of God. Christmas is coming around the corner. New Year is around the corner also. This is always the time. Niro, Salo, Ozalo, Mulayo, Mafre, Loka, Upper Court, Bugwe, Ati, Down Court, and Left Court, everything. Man, Dabwe, Daku, Ozalo, Dan. You know what I'm saying? So listen, Christmas is coming. New Year is coming. You know what I'm saying? Baby is having a good time. You know what I'm saying? Bukola Saki Oye is having a good time. Olorilola is having a good time. Everybody's having a good time. All right. So we are planning for the new year because the new year is going to be great. All right. It's going to be a new beginning. We are going to clean the slate and we're going to start from A, B, C, D. A for apple, B for boy, for like a diva. I don't think you know A, B, C, or A, B, D. You're not start doing A for apple, B for boy. In January, we are going to elementary. Every one of us, we leave PhD level again. No, no. PhD here, oh, it did help you all. We are going to RBD, Olowe. That's where we're going. We have to go and start all over. And now build all the way up. It is time for us to actually, you know, drain your brain. Empty your brain. Okay? Take everything that is in your brain, take them out. And then we are going to start on a new ground. And we are going to make it in 2019. It doesn't matter if you are a divorcee watching me. Oh, you've been divorced, husband has run away and all kinds of stuff. All right? You know, do you take energy drinks? No, I don't know. It's only spirit though. You don't know. Oh, my God, don't bend on me. What is living inside of me is greater than what is living in this world. I am energized and propelled and activated by the Holy Ghost. You don't understand. You will know today. Now, even if you are a divorcee and you live in this world, listen to me. You are still a child of God. You are a child of God. There is a space for you in your Father's house. It doesn't matter what people say. It doesn't matter how they say it. You don't want anybody to push you behind the scene. Listen to me. You have to hold your head up. You have to stand up. Lift up your shoulders. Walk like the daughter of a king on the street. Talk like a queen. All right? Because your Father owns the universe. He doesn't belong to nobody. All right? You are a sinner because everybody is a sinner. Everybody is. Okay? The moment you become perfect, you don't have that qualification to stay here on earth. You are going to move to heaven. Perfect people don't live here. Only we people that have problems. We that are problematic people. Every day we go to God and say, Father, forgive us. Father, forgive us. God is not looking for us to be perfect. He know. He understood. He used to live here. He's got that understanding that we are not. All right? So without Christ in us, we cannot be perfect. So thank God for the blood. Thank God for the grace. Thank God for the mercy of God. Thank God for him giving his life unto us, you know, to actually become a cure to sin. All right? So when we swallow him, now we can actually become righteous and we stay righteous because we are in him. We are complete in him. Glory to God. I'm telling you, glory to God. Don't let anybody now come and be telling you otherwise. Don't let nobody destroy your joy. Don't let nobody make you to enter your shell. No. It's not the time. It's you don't let anybody now come and be telling you jargons and Jackie Robinson that will make your life miserable. No. You are beautiful. Even though you look like a gorilla inside the mirror, you look at yourself and say, this is a gorilla. Don't mind yourself. Oh. You are saying nonsense. Okay? You are beautiful. You are superlicious. You are cocalicious. You are everything licious. You are the best of God. God created you to be the best. All right, so when you see yourself in the mirror, appreciate what you see. Don't look at Denzel Washington. Don't be looking at Ali Berry. Don't be looking at Michael Jackson. Don't now be comparing yourself. No. You are beautiful in your world. You are the best of God. Your situation is not your definition. When they say they want to define you, if they don't define you because you're a married person, they don't give a definition because you're a divorcee. No, that's not who you are. Who you are is on the inside of you. It's your makeup. You are a beautiful woman. You are a go-getter. Okay? You are consistent. You are faithful. You are transparent. You are loving. You are caring. That's who you are. Because there's a God inside of you. Don't let nobody tell you otherwise. Don't let no preacher make you to go into your shell and feel like you are nothing. Don't let anybody reduce you to zero. You are the greatest in the hands of God. Let me tell you something. Look at yourself every day and tell yourself, I am the greatest. That's what Muhammad Ali, every time he's always talking about, I am the greatest, I am the greatest. All right, that's Muhammad Ali for you. And every time he step on the ring, it feels like that. Your confession is very important. What you confess with your mouth is very important. Confess positive about yourself. Positive about yourself. Tell yourself, I'm the greatest. I am prosperous. I'm making it. I am successful. I am beautiful. I am the best. All right? When you give yourself all of this validation, I'm telling you, your spirit will come out from you. You begin to see things that you are not seeing before. People will start embracing you. Because you are not embracing yourself, that's why others are not embracing you. You go and hide yourself in your corner. You go and hide yourself in one angle. You don't come out and mingle with people because, oh, I'm too short. Oh, I'm too fat. Look at me. I got big belly. One belly, one big fat belly. All right. I went to class. Everybody's got six pack. I look at them and say, ah, you guys look ugly. They say, what? I say, because me, I get one big pack. They say, ah, your own big pack is not good. I say, who told you that? My wife can sleep on it like a pillow. What does your own wife do to you? He was saying, I'm divorced. I said, no wonder. It is because of your six pack you are divorced. You got, my wife is not good with me. And we don't even sleep on the same. I said, it's because of this, your stupid six pack, stupid stuff. I said, but me, I have one big pack. My wife is still loving me. I feel good about myself. I love myself, even though there are some things I got to change. All right, I got to change the six pack. I mean, the one pack to two, three packs. You know, I got to look healthy for myself. I got to look good for my God, for my wife, and for myself. You know what I'm saying? That's the way you should run. I am the greatest. I'm the best of God. I love myself. All right, I love. In 2019, I'm going to love myself more. All right, I'm going to love myself more than how I love myself in 2018. I'm going to eat well in 2018. In 2019, I'm going to drink well. In 2019, I'm going to sleep well. I'm going to have a lot. Oh my God, you don't know. I will have lot and lot and lot of sex in 2019. It's going to be like sex is actually my gas. That if I don't have sex in a day, it's going to be trouble. I will so much pour it out. I will put it out there. What's that? Every day, every minute, every second, I'll be doing loving, 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 loving. All right, that's what I'm going to do. In 2019, I will do more of traveling. I will do more of eating out. I'm going to do more of everything. Okay? That's what I'm going to do. I'm telling you, in 2019, I will do more. For real. I'm going to take my relationship to a higher level. I'm going to destroy powers and principalities. I will knock the head of the devil down. I don't care what the devil looks like. I don't want to know what kind of power is God, but I believe I'm the best of God. I can destroy powers and principalities. All right? So I will knock them down because I'm going to be more faithful. I'm going to be more transparent. I will leave my phone on the table. I will. I'm going to leave my phone on the table. All right? And when it's ringing, I won't run to the phone. I will just be walking to the phone. I won't run out of the bathroom because of my phone is ringing. I won't do that. No, I won't. I will change. I'm going to change. I'm getting hot. Let me remove this thing before I die. You know what I'm saying? So this is how I'm going to leave my phone on the table. I will remove my password from my phone. I won't keep the password there anymore. Okay? I won't be running out with soap all over my body when my phone is ringing in the living room. I won't be carrying my phone to the bathroom. I won't hide my phone again in the freezer. My phone, it doesn't belong in the freezer. My phone belongs on the table. I will put my phone on the table when I'm taking a shower. I will take the password out of it. All right? I will remove every barricade, every chain on my phone. I will be more transparent. I will be more faithful. I will be more caring, more loving in 2019. I'm telling you, I'm going to have a lot of sex in 2018. For real, I will look younger. I will look younger. I will have so much connection with my wife. That's what I'm going to do in 2019. It's a new year. It's a year of my no nonsense. I don't want to take any nonsense in 2019. You see, all of you guys that always give me nonsense, you better go and be careful. You better feel me now. I'm not going to take any nonsense in 2019. In 2019, I'm going to rebuild my business. In 2019, I'm going to rearrange my ministry. In 2019, I'm going to rearrange my house. I'm going to do well in business. I'm going to do well in academics. I'm going to do well maritally. I'm going to do well in the ministry. I will do all I can do. It's just not going to be like, this is going to be my last year. Okay? I'm going to enjoy it to the fullest of it. I'm going to make sure that everybody around me, they could feel it. You will feel it that Pastor Shola is enjoying his life. All right? 2019. That is my year of no nonsense. I won't take nonsense in 2019. No. All right? So, now this morning, my topic is three things that you need to understand about your wife before you enter into 2019. Three solid things that you need to understand. Number one, your wife is not your daughter. Oh, my goodness. You see, for so many years, I've been counseling people. I've been counseling people. And I found out with the language that they always use in my office, they refer to their wife as if to say, she is their daughter. Then I'll come down and say, come and understand something. Your wife is not your daughter. You can't be disciplining your wife. You can't be correcting your wife. You can't be, instructing your wife. You are a partner in the home. That woman is you. You have to understand that she is not your daughter. She is you. How can you treat your wife as a person, as part of you? How can you do that? Then they will stand out telling me, oh, maybe I should be now transparent. Maybe I should carry her along. Of course, you don't have any reason to carry your daughter along because she's your daughter. You instruct your daughter and tell your daughter to kneel down there, go and sleep, lock the door on yourself, and all kinds of stuff. Lock the door on yourself and go and sleep. You can put your daughter on timeout. You can't put your wife on a timeout. You can't tell her to go and sleep and lock the door. You can't tell her she's grounded. No. You can't say that. That is not your daughter. That is your wife. You have to give her the respect. The respect that you should give to that you want to give to yourself. The respect that other people should give to you. That's what you should give to your wife. Respect your wife. Just like you will respect yourself. The way you want her to respect you, respect her like that. All right? That's the way it is. Number two, your wife is not your mother. She is not your mother. Don't come here, me. He didn't give me a salary. I don't even know where a salary. Which one be your own? Is here? Does she have to give you a salary? I used to preach about joint account, because I changed my mind, though. I've come to understand that so many people are just so devilish that they cook up a lot of stupid stuff. He said, you can do joint account if the head of the husband is correct, the head of the wife is correct. If the head of the two of you are not really correct together, you have to be correct separately. It is better for you not to do joint account. You stop crying and stop whining about a woman not give you salary. You are waiting for your wife's salary every month so that you can go and drink. You are waiting for your wife's salary to pay bills. You are waiting for your wife's salary to go and be doing what? What kind of nonsense is that? All right, and you're whining. She didn't give me a salary. She's making 5,000, and she only dropped 2,000. Just shut up and go to sleep. Something is wrong with your head. She is not your mother. She's not supposed to be catering for your need. No. That's not what she's created for. She's supposed to be a supporter. Okay, treat her as one. Okay, treat her as one. That's exactly the way you should treat her. Okay, that's the way you treat her. Please, somebody, please don't call me. Please don't call me right now. Okay, that's exactly what it is. All right. So as you're actually growing up in 2018 and 19, you begin to understand, number one, that woman is not your daughter. You can't discipline her. You cannot say you are directing her. You cannot say you are instructing her. You guys are partners in the relationship. Number two, that woman is not your mother. You don't depend on her. You are not supposed to depend on her for nothing. No, sorry, sir. You are not depending on that woman for your whatever. For to pay bills, to buy your gas in your car, to go and build a house, to do it. You are not depending upon her salary. She is not your mother. Go and meet your mother in Ibadan. Go and meet your mother in Abeokuta. Let them go and be catering for your need if you are actually refuse to work. If you are not a good person that don't have brain to work, or you don't have any hands, you allow pastor less, yeah? Go and meet your mommy. Let your mommy be feeding you. Alright? Not her. If you want your marriage to be stabilized, you want your marriage to go to the next level, like I said the other day, what brought you to this point cannot take you to that point. Which point am I talking about? Everybody is dreaming of happy home. Everybody is dreaming of happy marriage. Everybody is dreaming of, oh, I want something good in my life. All right? Now, you can't be treating your wife as a daughter and get to that point where you find something good. You can't be treating your wife as a daughter and be able to get to that level of having marital bliss. It's not going to happen. Number two, you can't be treating your wife as if to say she's your mother. Okay? She's supposed to be the one to cater for your need. She's supposed to be the one to provide for your need and get to that level. You can't. Number three, you cannot make your wife your ATM machine. Alright? She is not your... This one resembles the second one. You cannot make her to be your ATM machine. O kan lo swipe card ye, o swipe card ye lojojumo o gbo wo jade. You are taking money. You are a thief. O le nia, and that is what made you to be where you are today. You have been a thief from January 2018 and you are still a thief today and you got nothing to show for it. It is time for you in 2019 to become ATM to your wife. Become that woman's ATM. Let her be swiping her own card on you and be taking money out. You will get respected. You will be respected. You will be loved. You will be cherished. They will reference you. They will honor you. They might not worship you, but let me tell you something. They will love you. Be the ATM machine. Go and look for something to do. And tell yourself, I'm going to go and look for something to do. I will be the breadwinner in this family. I will become the ATM machine. Mama, I will vomit money inside this house. Whenever they need anything, all I got to do is to cough. When I cough, money will come out. They will respect you. You will see that kind of respect they will give unto you. It's actually, I'm telling you, it works like magic. All right? It was amazing. Because when you obey the law of God and when you are in the law of God, working according to the law of God, you begin to see the way it's going to work. So as a man, you see, always expect your wife to support. Don't expect your wife to lead. Your wife is not created to lead. The moment you put her in the position of leading, there will be something that will be messed up in that relationship. That relationship will never be normal. You don't want your wife to lead at all. Alright? You want to actually put everything together, try so hard, put all effort together to be able to become the breadwinner. Number one, like I said, that your wife is not your daughter. Hello? I'm repeating it over. Your wife is not your daughter. All of this stupid language that say, I discipline her. Who are you to discipline your wife? Oh, I give her time out. Is she your daughter? Why are you giving her time out? Oh, I'm not going to touch you for 2 weeks. Who be you? Who you be? And where you come from? Are you me? Am I you? Is it, you know, that kind of, what is that? Is you? What is that? You are not supposed to, that language is not supposed to be in relationship. Discipline is not a word for relationship. All right? Correction is not a word for relationship. You compliment one another. It's not about complimenting. And then you are going to be able to put whatever it is that is not in your wife, you put it in her. True love. Love. You do whatever you do by love, with love. By loving your wife, you don't capitalize on the wrong things she's doing. You don't capitalize on her fault and errors. Help her to stay away from error. Help her to stay away from error and mistakes. How will you do that? Always give her validation. Appreciate what she's doing that is correct. All right? Appreciate all what she's doing that is right. It's not always that what she's doing that is wrong with what you will be showing up.
I want cookie. You didn't give me cookie.
How about the time she's been giving the cookie and you didn't appreciate the cookie? You didn't appreciate it. How about the time she's been cooking that you didn't appreciate the cook? How many times have you taken time to say thank you, my dear, for this food that you have cooked? This is the most wonderful meal I've ever eaten in my life. Alright? Yeah, have you ever done that? You want to treat your wife as a daughter? She's not.
She's not your daughter. No wonder your house is not set to be. The woman will rebel. That woman will rebel against you. She will never in this world listen to what you got to say. There will be trouble in that house daily. Because if you refuse to appreciate her, if you refuse to encourage her, if you refuse to compliment her, you are actually treating her as if to say she's your daughter. But she's not. Number two, that woman is not your mother. You don't want to treat her as a mother. She's not. You don't depend on her. She's the one praying for me. She's the one washing my clothes. She's the one making the bed. She's the one giving me money. She's the one doing this. Are you stupid? Is there anything wrong in your life? Your mommy, like I said yesterday, your mommy is not proud of you. Your mommy has wasted all her effort. You finally end up like your dad. Your mommy, she is disappointed in you. Very, very disappointed. Everything she put into you, just for you not to become like your daddy. You ended up becoming like your daddy. Irresponsible man. Alright? Somebody that is not appreciative. Alright? You have ended up to be like him. The woman's prayer has been destroyed. Effort has been made so. You just ended up. You are just like your daddy. I'm telling you, you don't think. Your head is not correct. You see, one thing I always like people to do is look at your own father as a man. Look at your dad. Look at what he had done wrong. Look at everything that he did to your mother that you feel like is wrong. All right? And then you now say to yourself, I'm not going to repeat this same thing. This thing is going to die in my lineage. My own son will not learn this one from me. My own children will not learn this one from me. So you will now be able to change things around. It's about decision. You have to make up your mind that this is not going to happen. If your daddy was a bully when he was married to your mommy, and all kinds of stuff, he beat up your mom like anything, slap your mom anyhow, you make up your own mind that I'm not going to be like my father, okay? And then you change everything all around. You try as much as possible not to do that. She is not your mother. You cannot be slapping her around. You can't be beating her. She is not your daughter. She's not your mother. She's not your daughter. You can't be abusive. You can't. He said, any man that is yelling at you, yell back at the person. Say, which one you did? Will you like it when somebody is yelling at you? Will you like it when somebody is yelling at you? You always yell. Well, I come get a mess or a mess or I'm a shabby. I just let you. Kilo worry life. Kilo silly. I hear to kilo be tongue. You know, all that kind of stuff. We are then be talking to her, and then the next thing, okay, yeah, you see that yelling. Which one be your own? If anybody should yell at you, yell back at the person. Say, which one you look like? Mama, na yell at you, mama yell, mama yell. I'm best or give you paruosi. You know, we are talking to you and I. Odo pa no the yelling. Odo pa one. What benu tava fa alaba for di. Odo what benu temi fa alaba for di. Joko si benya kaso rojare. Kilo shori e dimeji. Choko. You know, I let him sit down. I say, Odo pa one. You can't be yelling here. We are supposed to talk like mature people, responsible, cool-headed, somebody with brain. We talk maturely. Dialogue delay. This is what they call dialogue. Stop yelling. In 2019, there is no room for yelling. No room for all this yelling and you say, I am angry. Don't be angry. There is nothing like angry anger in 2019. In 2019, we're going to have to sit together and start settling things. Okay? You might be irritated. You might be angry. You might not like what I did. But let me tell you, you have to connect to what I've done that is correct. And then you make it, you're gonna make that your standard. And then you sit down with me, and we sit on the same couch, and we talk things heart to heart. And we discuss things. Because we have individual differences. We don't see things the same way. You might be seeing 6, I may be seeing 9. So give me a reason to see your 9. You give me a reason to see your 6. That's what they call relationship. Relationship is all about making other person to see what you see. All right? Making them to see what you're seeing. Because what you're seeing may be different from what they are seeing. You don't judge them because they don't see what you see. Make them to see it. Then they're going to flip around and then come to your own side. And then they find out that this is a 9, not a 6. And then they tell you to come to their own side. Then you go to their own side. You find out that the same 9 can actually become a 6. Oh my God. You see, that's just the issue. Ability to see from the eye of the second person. Ability to understand where they are understanding from. Ability to step in their shoes and be able to see what they are really seeing or what they are hearing from what you're saying. You might say, I'm going to Dubai. And the person may hear, maybe probably you want to move out of the house. And you say, but I said I'm going to Dubai. And they say, I'm moving out of the house. Okay? Make them to understand where you're going. Make them to get the point correctly. Alright? Make them to do so. So, your wife is not your daughter, your wife is not your mommy. Don't be crying and be whining because of our money. Don't be saying you are disciplining your wife, you are doing this, that. You have no right to do that. Number three, your wife is not your ATM machine. You don't come here be collecting money all the time. The woman is tired. Very tired. We were talking about the woman online the other day. The woman who gave her husband 150 million naira to go and buy a house in Lekki area and all kinds of stuff. So I went and I interviewed the lady. I was chatting with her. I said, hey, madam, 150 million is not a joke. She said, yes, I know. He said, I was able to save that money. I said, for how many years? He said, for a long time. This woman happened to be a surgeon, or else she's a surgeon, and she's earning a lot of money. So she was able to save the money in course of the years, and then she got married, and the husband just got the money from her, went and bought a house, and made his brother to move into the house without rent. And the woman is asking, come on, man, how can I invest $150 million in a business and don't get any updates? I need updates. I need you to tell me what's going on. How much money is coming to my account? I don't get any money. I've not been seeing any alert on my phone. How much money are you making? Later, the woman found out that the brother is living in the house for free. Okay? It's not your money. That's your wife's money. She sweat to make that money. And she want to do business. She's not doing charity. Not charity. So you don't turn your wife to be an ATM machine because she's may have money and she's a doctor. Doesn't mean that you have to be spending her money lavishly. No. You have to respect her. Respect that money also. Respect the mind behind giving you, committing the money into your hand. So you have to treat that money as if to say that money is from you, that you have to go to went to work for so many hours to make that money, that you are not supposed to squander it. You don't disrespect the owner of the money and then at the same time destroy and disrespect the money itself. No, you don't do that. That's not the way you handle things. So for you men, I'm going to broadcast for women tomorrow. The broadcast for women is coming tomorrow. But for you men out there, listen to me. It is time for you to understand what you need to do in 2018. All of this mambo jumbo, crazy, stupid stuff you did in 2018 didn't take you far. This one didn't take you far. It got you to this stupid level. The level that you find yourself right now is not a good place. And I know that you will agree with me that you are not finding it easy right now. The woman has suddenly turned to be a nag. Why is she a nag? What is wrong with her head? Why is she always shouting? There was one particular man that came to me. He said, Pastor, I do not understand. I don't understand what my wife is looking for. She's always shouting. I don't know. She's a nag. So when I interviewed the woman said, Pastor, is that what she's saying? He said, yeah. He said, Pastor, this man, we don't know how much he's making. We don't know how much is in the bank account. All I know is he's borrowing money, and he will come home by 3 o'clock in the morning every Friday. Why won't I hear? Why won't I be yelling? I said, madam, it is compulsory to yell. I called the brother and said, all this nonsense you are doing, I'm telling you. I'm telling you, someday you will come back, you won't meet that woman there again. She's getting tired right now. He says, how do I get to the next level? I asked him, how do you want to get to the next level? How do you want to make peace with your wife? He said, by stop staying at home and stop spending money all around. I said, how desperate are you to do it? He said, very, very desperate. I said, between 1 and 10, 10 being the highest, how desperate are you? He said, 10. I said, good for you. That means you are actually ready. Okay? That means you are actually very ready to be able to make this work. And thank God for their life. The man changed. And ever since that time, the woman kept quiet. She kept quiet. So what you did in 2018 that didn't work for you, you don't bring it over to 2019. It's not going to work for you. It's not going to work for you. No. You can't be cheating and the woman will be at peace. Okay? You can't be fornicating and the woman will be at peace. You have to go and say no more fornication in 2019. And actually, you got to start right now. Okay? Start this moment that you're listening to me. Then you will see another result. The result that you will see in 2019 is going to be a result that you never even think about. You have so much peace. Your wife will be so connected to you. Food will be on time. Everything will be on time. That's what you're going to see. All right? But if you continue with this same life you're living, you're hiring native, putting stupid chain in your neck, chewing gum all around the place, and going to party, club, club. You will still be seeing the same thing. the woman will still be reacting the same way. The reaction will not change. It will be the same reaction. You try it. Stop going to party. Stop drinking. Stay home. No clubbing. When you want to drink your gouda, drink it at home. Let your wife cook the pepper soup. You will begin to see a different woman in 2019. You won't believe yourself. I'm telling you. You will not believe yourself. What you will see in 2019 will daze you. You will say, so this woman can actually behave correctly. Of course, she can behave correctly. She needs a foundation to sit upon. She needs you. She is looking for you to accept her, to be with her, stay with her, provide for her, stay with her in the house. That's what she's expecting. If you are the kind of a bully, you are always shouting, you this stupid woman, you are not good for anything. Get out of this house. Oh, man, you don't know nothing. And that's why she's behaving like that, though. She's actually blocking you. You are reaching a brick wall every time because of your attitude, the way you speak to her. You disrespect her in front of the people. You disrespect her in front of your family. And all kinds of, I know you are expecting her to be normal. She can't be normal. I will not let her be normal. Even me myself, I will tell her to become abnormal. Okay? And she will give you pepper. All right, when you are having sex, there's one other woman that said, the man said, Pastor, this woman, I don't think she's interested in me. Every time we're having sex, she will just sleep there like a log of wood. The woman said, Momange di de tele, Momange di segbe, get this bebe, Momang for so, keep myself, bebe, me, oh, les, eh, ma. When he said, Dibosa, well, I will get the massa. Well, get you, one get the food, tele, well, get the woman bouncy, one bouncy be ball, lunike, well, a bouncy man. And the woman said, I will just sleep there like a log of wood. Me again, the man. Madame Kilo Seller. He will abuse me in the afternoon, abuse me in the evening, abuse me everywhere. But almost if I'm again, the man. I will sleep there. Let him do the work. I'm enjoying it. Let him do the work, yo. And so, and I said, you see, sir, you are the man. You are the one that is causing this thing. You are the one that is causing it. You cause this thing, finish now. You are now saying, kidding on. No. You need to stop insulting the woman. You need to make her happy. When you make her happy in the afternoon, make her happy in front of your friends, in front of your relative, when night time will come, oh my God, oh my God, the kuni. Oh my God! Is this my other wife? Is this my wife or another person? Oh my! You don't know the kind of talent she's got. She's a talented person. Talented, giddy. Oh my God! That's the stuff I'm telling you. You need to understand that stuff. Oh yeah. This is not about Bible. Bible will not work for you. You see, it's your character. Your character is bad. You go to church, you are outside in church, you are in clinic on church, but your character is bad. You can't still enjoy. Pray from morning till night. You roll over. Nothing will happen. You are just praying for fun. Okay, there is nothing inside that prayer. Nothing inside that prayer. All this prayer you are praying is just nonsense. All right? Because you disrespect your wife. That's not a good thing to do. It's not the right thing to do. You know what I'm saying? It's not a good thing to do. So you need to go and see it the way it is. You are supposed to be a provider for God's sake. A man that is a provider, we actually enjoy the respect from him or from a woman. Become a provider. Your wife will be so happy that you are bringing home money. Your wife will be happy that you are bringing home money. You are supplying the need. She's not running all around because, you know, she's not afraid that maybe the mortgage will not be paid or maybe the mortgage will be paid. She's not afraid. Okay? The assurance is there for her. She's assured that the money is going to be paid. She will love you. She will love you to the end of her life. She will give you whatever it is that you want her to give you. She will cut her head for you. I'm telling you. All you need to do is to respect her. All you need to do is to give her assurance. Okay, let her have the security needed. That's all she needs. Be the man. And I say this all the time. Gbogbo awon sisi ton li ekiri. All this sisi that is going all around the place. Fine boy, won canary. Everywhere on Facebook, they are running after you. On ground, they are running after you. Inside the church, they are running after you. Well, they are only lying to you. What be gbowo owo eni o? Your kokoro is so tiny like this. Who can manage it one time? Je oni, imagine you are the best. Oh, you rock my world. Oh my God, imagine I just love you. I wish I married to you. Oh my God, imagine you are so fine. You are so this. You are really endowed. You run one part of me. What the hell? Who don't fool when you're not back? You are buying them these watches. You are buying shoes. You are buying everything. That's what they are taking. Only anyone. You, all of you are just thief. They are just lying to you. They are collecting your money. The time you will lose your job, that money will not come again. You will lose your money. You will lose your house. You will not be expecting all those fine girls to be running after you. What drive will BMW? What kojale bedan? Which one you be? Who you be? Who you be? That's the day you remember. You will now be looking for your wife toting napa. Yahweh told napa. That's your wife that you beat. You insulted her. You be like, I am sorry. Eshuni. Tell him in Yahweh, man. Odo Eshugandu alomangbe. Omu Eshuto lo fa fifim. Omu engani ko lo denu boko ma falo. Oye. Odo Eshuye ni ko malo sinabo levesu. Oye. Ibe Maliedanu. Eshukin. This is the Ankle of Wednesday. We are telling you right now, it's here that be it's here. You won't listen now. We are Ankle of Wednesday. It's here on the boat. Why am I saying kakakaka be anywhere on the column of Bobo? We are here though. Any pami? I'm telling you. Any pami? Oja loksime don't go cool down, go bang at Iazo. You're just here, you're just listening. Any pami? Why not? You will remember this video one day. You will remember. Oh, woman flashes in the memory, right? In the memory card, you are full up. What car flashes? You don't see your joy. It's in your bow. No, you beat your wife, you do all those kind of things, and send her away. Now, your head will be correct. Well, you will not understand. You will understand. So this is it. This is it, though. So, number one thing is that your wife is not your daughter. Your wife, number two, is not your mother. Number three, your wife is not your ATM machine. The moment you are able to correct these three things in 2018, before you enter 2019, life will be better. Life is going to be better. All you need to do is just correct this and see where you're going to get to.
I just want to exalt the name of the Lord.
Whoa.
Immortality. Hallelujah. Oh, God, for love. My faith to feel.
Being both of us, thank you, Darren.
Toto Farachi be okay. Oba mi tinje fadirira. Alagbara to labu ayeja. Ikile la ti ko le ye. Oba to bola. Oba mi enila ti gbadun bale awon ba. Atori tan, atoba tan. O be ni ja, eru ko bo ni ja. Aduro pe npa le ya so tito. Oba mi afashe so jade. Oh, Lord, God, baby, I'm a mythico, you pada,
oh, bala,
cause you're
yeah. Oh,
love
for me, thank you guys, thank you very much, man. Thank you, everybody, thank you. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you. For the men out there, I'm not against you guys. All I want to do is for you guys to actually go and amend your ways, do the right thing. It's not about praying. Listen, it's not about praying. It's not about just reading Bible. It's about your character and your attitude. You just got to change it. You just got to do the right thing. So when you do that, you're going to see a change. You know, what you've been asking for, what the kind of a woman you want your wife to become, you're going to see. In 2019, you're going to see that woman. I'm not kidding. The kind of woman you are actually thinking and dreaming to marry, that's what your wife is going to become. All you need to do is just to treat her correctly. Treat her right. And when you do that, you know, you will see. That you I'm telling you, you don't have to pray for God to be able to bless your home. You don't have to pray for God to bless your home. All you gotta do is just to do the right thing. Love your wife as Christ loved the church. That's it. Very simple. Very, very simple. Alright? So when we do that, you're gonna be greatly blessed. Come on, everybody, show me some love, man. Show me love. Show me some love. I gotta go.
Hallelujah.
Louis Aromira, how are you doing? In your booty, yeah. You were late. You didn't come on time. All right, guys. Thank you very much. And I see you, Pastor Remy. Adi Remy Badru. Please call me. I've been trying to chat with you on WhatsApp. You're not responding. Please call me. We got to talk. Thank you, everybody. God bless you. And see you guys later on the flip side. Bye.